woke from the very same dream he had 100 times before. It was a pancake breakfast with maple syrup, bacon and sausage, and so much more. The dream seemed so real, he could almost taste it now. Then he was jolted back to the harsh reality. His mother said, "Jack, go sell the cow." Whoa, Jack, cut him some slack. Na 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 na. Whoa, Jack, you better get back. Na 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 na. He met a man on the side road, gave him a handful of beans, but his mother threw them out the kitchen window. She didn't believe in magic, it seems. Next day, Jack looked out. He couldn't believe his eyes. Then he climbed and climbed and climbed and climbed the magic beanstalk into the skies. Whoa, Jack, cut him some slack. Na, 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 na. Whoa, Jack, you better get back. Top of the beanstalk, he found a castle in the clouds. And then a fee-fi-fo-fum knocked him over thunder and loud. He found a place to hide in the kitchen while the giant counted his gold. And then he fell asleep. Jack snuck out, stole a sack full of coins so bold. Whoa, Jack, cut him some slack. Back up the beanstalk and hid in the kitchen again. He heard a fee-fi-fo-fum. I smell the blood of an Englishman. The giant sat in his great big chair, soon began to snore. And then Jack grabbed the hen that lays golden eggs and hightailed it out the back door. Whoa, Jack, cut him some slack. Up the beanstalk, he took the magic harp that could sing. But the harp cried out, woke up the giant, just about ruined everything. Back home, Jack grabbed an axe and gave the beanstalk a mighty chop. And then the giant tumbled down to the ground, from high in the sky with a flip-flap-flop. Whoa!